Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button below and clicking the bell icon to be notified whenever we publish a new video.
Kidney disease can be broken down into 5 different stages, each with a reference to an acronym known as GFR. GFR stands for glomerular filtration rate and describes the flow rate of filtered fluid through the kidney. That normal GFR is 120 to 125 milliliters per minute. Kidney disease stage 1. GFR 90 plus. Slight kidney damage with normal or increased filtration. Kidney disease stage 2. GFR 60 to 89. Mild decrease in kidney function. Kidney disease stage 3. GFR 30 to 59. Moderate decrease in kidney function. This stage is considered the beginnings of kidney failure. Kidney disease stage 4. GFR 15 to 29. Severe decrease in kidney function. Kidney disease stage 5. GFR 14 or less. Kidney failure requiring dialysis or transplantation. Also known as end-stage renal disease. Whom does it affect? Every year 100,000 plus people from the USA are diagnosed with kidney failure. 60 years old and above is the most common age bracket to have kidney failure. Hispanic, African American, Asian, Pacific Islander, and Native American people are more susceptible. 1 in 6 adults have kidney disease. How can you tell if you have kidney disease? Unfortunately, kidney disease and kidney failure can sneak up on people, a silent killer. In the early stages of development, kidney disease is asymptomatic, without symptoms. Eventually, a day of critical mass occurs when enough of the slowly progressing disease initiates bodily signs and symptoms. Your body has tried to cope for some time, but now it is all too much and it begins to show physical signs and symptoms such as anemia, high blood pressure, BP rises due to excess fluid retention, which in turn causes fluid in the lungs. Not only does this cause breathing difficulties, but can also lead to congestive heart failure, decrease in mental function and possibly coma, fluid retention, swelling, high acidity in the body or metabolic acidosis, due to the inability of the body to produce bicarbonate. This will change oxygen and enzyme metabolism, leading to organ failure. High potassium levels in the blood or hyperkalemia is related to heart arrhythmias. High urea levels in the blood or uremia can affect brain health, increase tissue inflammation and reduce muscular function. Lethargy. Loss of appetite. Shortness of breath. Weakness. Other symptoms include abnormally dark or light skin. Agitation. Blood in the vomitorian stools. Breath odor. Decreased alertness, including drowsiness, delirium. Decreased sensation in the hands, feet, or other areas. Easy bruising or bleeding. Excessive nighttime urination. Excessive thirst. Frequent hiccups. General ill feeling. Generalized itching or pruritus. Headache. Increased or decreased urine output. Muscle twitching or cramps. Nail abnormalities. Unintentional weight loss. White crystals in and on the skin. Acute kidney failure symptoms, on the other hand, is pronounced, obvious, and has a rapid progression. Abdominal pain. Body swelling. Confusion. Decreased urine production. Diarrhea. Fatigue. Lethargy. Metallic taste in the mouth. Nausea, vomiting. Problems concentrating. Seizures and coma may occur in very severe acute kidney failure. Health, more than the absence of disease, health is the state of physical, mental and social well-being, a state in which a person feels at every moment of living a joy and zest for life, a sense of fulfillment, and an awareness of harmony with the universe around them.
There are many natural therapies available. Combined with appropriate dietary and lifestyle changes, you can both reverse kidney damage and protect from further damage to your kidneys in the future. Get an effective step-by-step program proven to start healing your kidneys today. Take action by clicking the link below. You'd be surprised how well this works.
If you're ready to take action, click on the link below this video now.